Every year, the UK exports over 1 million cars to the rest of the world. In Southampton, head of terminal, Pete Lavelle.
Without bigging myself up too much, I'm everybody's go-to man.
And his colleague, Phil Day.
Every day's a crisis, and I kind of like that part of it.
Are responsible for loading 750 luxury British cars worth over £25 million onto one of the world's biggest vehicle carriers. The cars, each in a protective wrapping, are destined for Baltimore in the United States, where they'll be unloaded by Phil's counterpart. They must be loaded in just 13 hours because vehicle carrier Titania is sailing for Baltimore at 2 a.m. and will leave with or without them. But already Pete has a problem. Titania is running late into Southampton.
She was slightly delayed last night. We were due to have her here for a 1 o'clock start. So we've asked the vessel to speed up. She's been doing maximum speed, just under 20 knots for the last few hours, just to try and make up a little bit of time.
The delay is caused by bad weather in the North Sea.
Because the berth that she's going to be working on today has to be clear by 2 o'clock tomorrow morning for a cruise ship coming in.
If they have to turn up the engines, it costs that much more if you're pushing the ship for speed. I mean, these vessels are pretty huge, really. You know, it's over 200 metres long, so it takes a lot to push it through the water.
If she doesn't make the window, then not only have we spent extra money on burning fuel by making her go faster, but we're also going to have a substantial amount of labour that are going to be sat around that we can't utilise for any other job. I'm hoping you've got some good news for me. Yep. And the pilot's just getting on board now.
It's not the good news Phil was hoping for. Titania is late, and the team now has 2 hours less than planned to load the 750 cars. If they're not on board on time, the team could be faced with hundreds of thousands of pounds worth of cars stranded on the dock.
Just make it plain to everyone that we've got to be off the berth by 0200, so we need to be as efficient as we can with the operation.
The Titania is a 228-metre roll-on, roll-off cargo ship. She's specially designed to carry up to 7,800 vehicles across 13 decks. To get safely into dock, she is relying on William Matthews and his 25-metre tugboat.
Titania, can you inform the crew we're running out of port side, please, for the heaving line?
Yeah, Roger.
Roger, thank you.
To pick up the tow line, William's 230-ton tugboat must come within just a few metres of the 74,000-ton giant.
The most dangerous for the tug to do is to go ahead of it, which is what we're doing now. We get in position ready, pick up the pace of the ship, so as he's reducing speed, and then when he's at 8 knots or 7 knots, we then make the final approach to pick up the line. OK, we're down to 7 knots now, Aidan, so got to be cautious that the tug doesn't get drawn into the ship. There's like a negative pressure effect which draws the two together. Hessen Bridge, all fast, Aidan, thank you.
The tow line is aboard, but berthing a ship this size is a delicate operation for the tugs. If Titania were to crash into the dockside, the effects could be catastrophic.
Hessen in a quarter
position. Roger, Hessen, push a quarter. He's parallel to the berth. We're pushing the stern of the ship in, closer to the quay, and he would be using the bow thrust to push the bow in the same direction, so the ship's bodily moving sideways to starboard now.
Hessen, all stop.
Roger, Hessen, stop.
Titania is leaving in just 11 hours. Each of the 750 cars must be driven from a holding car park almost a kilometre away. To stay on track, a car must be loaded every 53 seconds for the next 11 hours.
We are time pressed with all the problems that we were facing this morning and challenges. 2 o'clock in the morning is our cutoff.
Luckily for Pete, Titania comes equipped to get vehicles on quickly.
Massive great big ramp on this one. She's 9.5 metres wide, and we could run a unit over here that weighed 320 tonnes. Monstrous piece of steel, hooked onto the back of the ship, so quite a phenomenal piece of engineering.
This means the ramp could take the weight of 125 Range Rovers driving onto it at the same time.
She's fully adjustable in the middle, she's hinged, and the angle of it can be changed so that we can continue cargo operations regardless of the state of the tide and how far below the quay wall that the vessel is actually sitting. The Land Rovers are coming on board at quite a rate. Hopefully we're looking to get about 750 units away today, but of course we are time pressed with that.
Titania will sail for Baltimore at 2 a.m. with or without the valuable cargo. If anything is left behind, customers in Baltimore will be left without their new cars.
This car's just moving into final position. The stower is very integral to this. So he's making sure that the spacings in between the cars are correct from side to side. The bumper to bumper distance is correct.
The cars are all lined up in their protective anti-scratch coats, waiting to be loaded. But they can't leave the dock until car inspector Philip Hill has checked the 75,000-pound vehicles one last time, using a seriously high-tech piece of kit.
Just checking the roof now for any sign of any impact on the truck or from overhanging trees and branches. The driver can scrape down the side of the truck, can damage wheel and tire, door, wing. I think that is damage from an overhanging branch. I need to view this one with a pair of steps over at the fence in a minute to see if there's any damage or whether it's just like a bird dropping mark.
But after further inspection, Phil determines the mark to be the work of bird, not man, and the car is allowed on its way. As night falls, the team have just 3 hours left to get the remaining 200 vehicles onto the vessel. Alison Koenig is one of 25 port operatives loading the Land Rovers.
Basically, we check round the car just to make sure there's no damage. Tyres are all pumped up, all that sort of thing.
And sometimes I get in the cars and I can't reach the pedals. It's embarrassing. Absolutely love it. Being a car freak, it's just lovely. To be totally honest, you know, this job, I think all you need is a pair of ears, because you've got to listen to what's going on. You need common sense, and obviously to be able to drive. Driven some amazing cars that I'd never, ever get to drive. Full lock. Kieran's given me hand signals to tell me which direction to go see. And then all I do is follow that. You're basically blind to where you're going, and they will guide you into the smallest spot, and then you'll get out and you'll think, how did I get in there? You know, it's a real good fun job. That's it.
As each car is parked, a barcode scanner logs it on board, ready for the team in Baltimore to unload once it arrives. Somehow, the team have managed to load all 750 cars in record time. And even with the delay, Titania is ready for departure at 2 a.m.
Anybody that came now would think it was a nice, quiet, tranquil evening. Wouldn't have seen the hustle and bustle that's been going on since just after 3 o'clock this afternoon, and just looks like a nice big vessel full of lovely brand new Jaguar Land Rovers. So we move on and next one tomorrow.
Yeah, see you, Dave. Thank you.
It's an 8-day crossing to Baltimore, where Phil's colleague, Marine Superintendent Spencer Hughes, faces his own battle to get the vehicles delivered to their new owners.
Do not put this back here. You will break my ship, all right?